creativity would equate to innovation. So you may not think of creativity in the standard sense of children playing in the backyard and coming up with their own games, but I think in the business world, unless you can be innovative, unless you can find new ways of developing your projects and new ways of marketing your product, you're not going to thrive in the industry, regardless of what that industry is. At some point, you need to stop referencing everything and you need to start coming up with your own ideas, that it's okay to be creative, it's okay to come up with new ways of looking at things. And it really hadn't occurred to me till third year university that that's what they were looking for. But you spend so much time during your school years repeating information that you've been fed, and they don't maybe teach you or allow you to come up with your own ideas. So I think when you hit the business world and you're in your career and you're starting to try to establish yourself to get ahead, to prove your value, to add value to your company, to your business, you need to be creative, you need to be innovative, or you're not going to be successful in your field, regardless of what it is. I mean, whether you're the receptionist coming up with a new way of greeting people that are coming to the company and making them feel welcome and making them feel valued, or you're the CEO that's coming up, like I said, with a new way of marketing a product or a different way of looking at your business so you can be successful. I mean, these are challenging times economically. You need to be a leader in the industry if you want to be successful and if you want to have your company thrive. And you have to do that through innovation. I certainly am a strong believer that you don't want to reinvent the wheel every time. So you would go back and look what I would go back and look at what other people had done. I would seek the advice of my colleagues. I would do research with what other companies in my industry had done to give me a starting point, to give me a sense of where to even begin to solve the problem. But as you move through that process, you're going to find things that work for you and things that don't. Things that make sense for your personal situation, things that make sense for your business, and things that don't. So for instance, there are tons of opportunities in my industry and in probably all businesses to go to conferences, to learn, to network. And I think those are incredibly valuable. If you sit through an 8-hour conference and you walk away with 2 or 3 bits of information that you didn't have before, 2 or 3 bits of information that you can apply to your own business and use those to be creative and to apply those to new situations that you come across, I think that's incredibly valuable. And I think that's where the learning comes into it. You must always be trying to add to your database, add to your knowledge, add to your experiences so you can apply those to new situations, hopefully in a creative way. I think there are certain times when it makes sense to follow what's already been done. So in some situations, creativity is not encouraged. If you've got a filing system that works well, if every single person that came into that job decided to be creative and find a new way of filing, it's probably a waste of energy. So there are certain, I think, established systems, established procedures that you need to follow. Certainly in business, the legal teams, the accounting teams, they all play a big part in how you conduct your business. And creative accounting is not encouraged in any business. You need to follow those procedures, and there's certain rules and regulations that go along with that. So I think the creative part of business comes in realizing how you can move within those rules and how you can and find new ways of adding value, but still making sure that you're meeting the regulations and meeting the bottom line and the reporting standards that you need to meet to function effectively. When I hear the phrase thinking out of the box, well, I think that's a business term for creativity, right? They're saying, and there are so many terms that people use now that people kind of cringe when they hear them because they've been so overused that they're just cliches now. But I think that is the term for creativity in the business place, thinking outside of the box. Innovation is the one that I like to use. It's actually one of our core values at the business that I work at. We want employees to take the initiative and to have the innovation to be able to come up with new ways of approaching things. Come to us with solutions. Come to us with ideas of how we can better our business, better the way we're doing things. And if they make sense and we can apply them and still meet the bottom line that we need to meet, still make sure that we're meeting our targets, but doing it in a new way that's going to add value or add a whole new twist to things. If you can stand out in the industry that you're in, it's going to be make a huge difference to your profit levels. I mean, we're a publicly traded company, and I'm in the mining industry. There's many mining companies out there. So when people are making an investment decision, do they want to come to my company or do they want to go to a different company? If you can stand out by being creative and by finding different ways of telling your story and showing that you're really adding value in areas that other companies aren't adding value, that may be the difference that makes people come to you versus another investment choice.